Hello!
Master Elf.
Yes!
We are watching Lord of the Rings.
The two towers.
Shaky
Part Gimli. Two.
The second tower.
Yes. The two titties.
Part two.
The Tale of Two Cities.
We're just really excited. Right now, you know, the people of Rohan are, you know, going to their little fortified
Helm's
little
deep.
Area, the deep place,
Helm's
you know.
Deep.
The deep place. I like the deep place.
Yeah.
The good place, the deep place. And let's be transparent. We're ready to jump into this. We've been here a while. We're going to be here for two more hours. So
yeah, buddy.
Not a market sub. Support the official release. Yeah. Check out our Patreon. Do full it. Uncut. Early access to all of our shows. Helps make our world go round. Like, share, subscribe. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Discord, TikTok.
Let's go.
These are the things.
Those are apps.
Let's get it. Silence thine phones and clench thine cheeks, for we shall begin.
She was a girl when they brought her father back dead. Cut down by orcs.
All right, you just cut straight to the fun convo.
Doomed to wait upon an old man who should have loved her as a father.
It's not your fault. You were possessed by dark magic.
What's her name again?
Miranda.
Miranda Otto.
I made some stew.
Miranda Alvarez.
Oh, what is that?
Yeah, yeah.
Is that
a dumpling?
Shrimp or horse meat?
It's
good.
Really? Nah, bro. You're
no,
so seasoning, man.
Disgusting.
Yeah, throw that shit away, bro. I feel you.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Told me a strange name. She wrote to war with Thangor, my grandfather. She cannot be eight.
What is happening?
Did he grow up with elves and get some of their magic or what?
87.
What?
Damn,
he's not 87. What
is happening?
It's a gilf, bro.
Said that your race had passed into legend.
There are a few of us left.
The Dinnernan Rangers?
Mm-hmm. Hence his relationship with an elvish lady.
Oh.
Because they're immortal and he lives like a really
say.
Long time. Yeah.
Aww. This is a dream. I missed her. Boy, baby, go Frodo,
unmanly. They look good together, though.
Mm-hmm.
Where is she? The woman who gave you that jewel.
About time.
This dude.
I'm not going to respond to you. I'm just going to keep thinking.
I'll leave my daughter here to die.
She stays because she still has hope.
She stays for you. She belongs with her people.
Wow.
Yeah.
Elrond.
You're all fucked it up.
No, don't do that. Don't be this guy.
It's not you, it's me.
Literally.
I'm not your elf kind. It was a dream.
Yeah.
This belongs to you.
It was a gift.
Keep
it. My lord.
I'm
talking to you.
I'm talking to you.
She's sailing to the Undying Lands. Lord has left her a kill.
Oh, no.
Hell no, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that guy's dead.
Y'all ain't hearing this man get his face eaten off?
Let's go, bro. Let's
get
go.
It.
Why would a scout attack?
Fucking dumbass one time.
He was an idiot scout.
Well.
Start shooting?
Yeah, start shooting.
You must lead the people to Helm's Deep.
I can fight.
No!
Let her fight!
For real.
She's got a lead.
They need a leader too.
He probably doesn't want to lose any more kin, you know?
Yeah, but you know what? Guess what? She's female in this world. Who's gonna listen to her if she's still the only kin?
Let's go!
Wow.
Let's go!
Oh!
Wow.
Keep firing with your unlimited arrows.
Don't dwell on it.
So
what
let's
are
get
doing?
It.
He just- Whoa! Whoa!
And now it begins.
Yes!
Oh,
yeah!
Yes!
Oh, no.
Yes!
It's Jonah!
More weight on it.
Oh my god, that owns. He
that
said,
sick.
Fuck that, I don't even
oh
need owns.
Seriously?
This is hilarious.
Oh my god, I forgot about that. That was so badass.
Oh my god.
What?
Bowl.
Jeez. Oh, God.
Damn right in the chest.
Bro, you guys are going so fast.
Next time, fuck around.
Why would you stop running, bro? Oh!
There's the heir of Isildur.
Oh my god. We know he ain't dead, though.
Nah, he ain't dead.
He can't be dead.
It's fucking one shit-eating orc.
Little tumble off the cliff.
Oh.
See
oh fuck.
Oh okay, my god.
You lied.
Inconclusive.
Get the wounded on horses, leave the dead.
That's so disrespectful.
It's fucking
they ain't got no time.
Down.
Yeah, I mean, what are you supposed to do? It's carved into the mountains, bro.
I'm sorry, this is not that fortified.
Yeah, no, exactly. Those are glasses. 4 to 5, man. I thought they were going to go underneath.
I guess this is
really that's got light. Light.
What? Really?
What the hell?
No shit. Damn, I didn't even remember that.
Lord Aragorn, where is he?
Dude, no, he can't be dead. Fucking Frida's mom made it.
To all our forces behind the wall.
One of those who cannot fight well.
Get him into the chains.
Saruman's arm will have grown long indeed if he thinks he can reach us here. Helm's Deep has one weakness. Without a wall is solid rock. For a small column in its base.
Seriously?
What kind of device could break down a wall?
Quit fucking meddling with things.
Yeah, how about you get the candle away from gunpowder, guy?
It would take a number beyond reckoning thousands to storm.
Kill this guy.
Attrition.
But my lord, there is no such force.
Have you not been outside?
Where he's literally gonna be like, are you not listening to what's outside
Jesus
of the walls?
Jesus Christ.
Dude. Yeah.
That's more than 10,000 people.
This night, the land will be stained with the blood of Rohan.
Fuck you,
shots, dude.
This is like 50k, dude.
All of this is going there.
Oh shit.
Hey, group!
Meanwhile.
Smoke to the south.
There is always smoke rising from Isengard.
Isengard.
And the wheels.
Dude, it stretches so far. That's like 100,000, damn it.
The war has started.
Rego!
That war horse?
Yeah, the horse had seen too much war.
It's the one he let free.
Came to aid him in his time of need.
Awesome. That makes me so happy.
Quit fucking dreaming of that guy, dude.
He is not coming back.
There is still hope.
There is always hope.
If Sauron is defeated and Aragorn made king, and all that you hope for comes true, Aragorn will die.
That's her choice. She wants to spend it with somebody she'll lose eventually.
I agree.
And there will be no comfort for you.
It's just standing there.
You will linger on in darkness and in doubt.
There's something to be said for being mean, but there's also something to be said for being honest.
Yeah.
He is being honest.
I mean, does she not know this already?
It's kind of nice to hear it sometimes.
There is nothing for you here.
Okay, Papa. I shall go.
No!
Okay,
follow
Papa.
Your heart.
I shall stay.
I love you, Papa.
I mean...
No.
That ain't wrong.
He's not wrong, but she still should make her own choice to follow her heart.
You trying to live? You trying to die?
She's not going
to
die.
I mean, she's gonna lose her husband. I mean, right?
I don't agree with that last little tactic there, but
What did he say?
He's like, don't you love me too? I don't know if I agree with that.
Manipulative asshole, but
I'm not manipulative.
Well, I don't know. It's a bit manipulative.
It's a different kind of love.
Yeah, he was laying.
You can have both.
Right. He was laying it out plain and simple before, which is fine. That's not manipulative. That's just saying it how it is. But when he's like, but don't you love me? That's.
But it's just asking the question. If you love him, then don't
but
you love me?
But the answer is to compare it to, I know you love him in a completely different way, but also don't you love me? You would stay for him, would you leave for me?
Yeah, it's unfair.
That's the part that's manipulative.
At least be happy now. She's doing what you want to do.
It's crazy.
Hey, we haven't seen you in so long.
Yeah.
Sauron will use his puppet Saruman to destroy the people of Rohan. The Eye of Sauron now turns to Gondor, the last free kingdom of men. He senses the rings close.
Oh, God.
The strength Frodo begins to understand. The quest will claim his life.
No!
You have foreseen the will of the ring grows strong. It works hard now to find its way back into the hands of men so easily seduced by its power.
Yep.
The young captain of Gondor has but to extend his hand, take the ring for his own, and the world will fall. The time of the elves is over.
I feel like they could do so much, though.
Yeah, they have all this fucking power. Why don't you do something? Try something and shit.
Why don't the elves fight?
They've been around for so long, they probably don't want to get involved in the worldly matters.
Mm-hmm. They know this is going to be about the end of the elves.
Well, they're leaving.
Yeah.
They're dipping.
Ah, so little bitches.
If you're not spies, then who are you?
We set out from Rivendell with 7 companions. One they lost in Moria. 2 were my kin. A dwarf there was also, and an elf, and 2 men. Aragorn, son of Arathorn, and Boromir of Gondor.
To grieve you, then. To learn that he is dead. His horn washed up upon the riverbank. He was cloven in two. It was my brother.
Aww.
Never again will the land of my people fall into enemy hands! For Gondor!
For Gondor!
For Gondor!
For Gondor!
He's here.
Who's that? Daddy?
Father dearest?
Correct.
Always you cast a poor reflection on me.
Damn, bro, come on, this is a celebratory time.
He loves you, father.
Do not trouble me with Fadmir. I know his uses in their
future. Oh my god!
This thing must cut the combo. Never the ring will seek to corrupt the hearts of lesser men, but you are strong.
Why would you assume that?
This binding this time, these massive, fresh armies, bring me back this mighty king.
You were sent to your death. I'm sorry, bro.
My own dad.
If he wasn't there, he wouldn't have saved Merry and Pippin.
Send me instead. You?
That's not one of your uses.
I trust this mission only to your brother, the one who will not fail me.
Damn, dog. Me dared than a motherfucker.
Aw, he's a sad boy.
Remember today, little
brother. Was that the last they saw each other?
Yeah.
At least he didn't say that when they meet again, they'll talk about his mother.
Smeagol, yay! Aww!
Join a nice dip, I would too.
Join. The forbidden pool bears the penalty of death.
Don't kill Smeagol.
How's he supposed to? Ain't no fucking sign.
Cool. I'm so cool.
Aww.
Let me go down to him.
You ain't ever had sushi, bro?
Master is here.
You must go now.
You must trust Master.
Oh my god, I can only their friends. Why?
Listen to me!
Why are you betraying?
Master lied to you. Oh, now Gollum's gonna come back out. Oh, Jesus. You are a bitch, Faramir.
Answer me.
That's pretty sad.
Frodo's kind of a bitch move.
I don't think Frodo knew they were gonna take him.
Oh, no, Gollum's coming back.
Yo, Gollum's coming back.
Why does he cry so
long? Oh, no.
No!
They stole it from us!
What did they steal?
Rations!
Use the ring, Mr. Frodo. Disappear.
No.
The ring's taking me, Sam. If I put it on, he'll find me. The ring of power within my grasp.
Boromir is a better brother than you.
Chance for Faramir, Captain of Gondor, to show his quality.
Just wants to impress Daddy.
Yup. Ain't gonna fuck up right here.
Oh,
you leave.
Oh shit, it got to him.
Don't you understand?
He's gotta destroy it!
Will you not help him?
Bro, come on, let him go.
We'll go to Gondor.
Fuck you!
His daddy gave him that complex that he ain't shit.
It's alright, the true king of Gondor is going back.
Manner of speaking.
Oh lord!
They coming.
The luckiest, the canniest, and the most reckless.
Oh, they're friends!
They're done.
I love their friendship so much. But that's not your bae.
Erica.
He likes somebody else.
She's but she's somewhere happy else right now, you know. It don't mean anything she ain't here.
She's happy because he's that ancient man species.
He don't love you.
And he's,
they all
she,
dying
isn't
out.
Isn't Arwen leaving to like
she did leave.
You think?
Oh shit.
That was sick.
Slow-mo.
He's an army bred for a single purpose. To destroy the world of men.
What else is new?
Be here by nightfall. These are Uruk-hai. Their armor is thick, their shields broad. I know how to defend my own keep.
Well, you did get freaking enchanted.
Fuck me, I guess.
If this is to be our end, then I would have them make such an end as to be worthy of remembrance.
And go down swinging, if anything.
Bro, everything he's done is for his people so far.
The old alliances are dead. Gondor answered. Where was Gondor when the Westfall fell? Where was Gondor when our enemies closed in around us? Where was Gondor?
Well, your ass was out, and we were stuck on that Helm's Deep.
The King's Moat, the Ent Moat.
Oh, I love them.
There, Groot is among one of these.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa, that guy's got dreads.
I like the Willow one.
All the different seedlings.
And they're all male.
Would you rather be in the group inside hiding or outside fighting?
Hiding. I'm sorry, those things are terrifying.
Fighting, I'd be too, my anxiety would explode me inside the cave.
Fighting, yeah.
These are gonna be out there doing something. Maybe like off in the back.
I'm to be sent with the women into the caves. Let me stand at your side.
It's not in my power to command.
I admire that she wants to fight.
You do not command the others to stay. They fight beside you because they would not be parted from you. Because they love you.
Oh my god. Are they taking the fucking boys to fight?
They should take all the fighting age lads.
That's James.
Hey.
Damn, that's fucked.
Right? If we had enough swords, I might put the fucking women
You're
out
literally
there too.
Taking them to their death, and you know that.
He called her shield maiden before, so that means they have that culture, so I don't understand why there are any women fighting.
Most have seen too many winters, or too few.
Too old and too young,
yo. They're frightened. I can see it in their eyes.
She said that loud, bro.
Yeah, maybe stick to the Elvish.
300 people?
You mean we?
Both making points.
Who am I, Gamling? You are our king, and you trust your king. Your men will follow you to whatever end.
I think it's one of those moments where you're in the 11th hour, you have your doubts. You have to do a thing, you maybe don't want to do a thing, but you kind of have to.
Aw, dude, are you fucking for real? This is like so dumb.
I know, like, I mean, what choice do they have though? Yeah, there's 300 out of the 10,000.
Like, they're exactly. Children, there's no point.
Well, I think it's to show the desperation of their situation.
Yeah. Damn, son looks a little badass though, don't he?
Sure, lay down some proximity mines, get some RPGs.
Right, don't they have weapons and shit like that? Like, no. At least give them those. We have dragons.
Trebuchets.
Whatever those are. See,
in the Tolkien universe, all the bad guys have dragons. None of the good guys have dragons. Okay. All the bad
but
guys.
But the should have something.
They just finished saying good morning.
Ah, it's night.
It's nighttime already. Running out of time.
Bro, if I were those kids, I would die, I would hide underneath a dead body.
Can't be a coward either, though.
I will be a coward.
Being a coward is like being a snitch out here.
No, I'll be a coward.
Also, if you're going to die either way, you probably just want to die
going fighting.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to just be in there and just die.
The men are saying we will not live out the night.
No, you're not.
They say that it is hopeless.
Mm-hmm. Alith, son of Elrond, there is always hope.
Aw, she said the same thing.
I was wrong to despair. Why?
He was just spitting facts, bro.
Notice he said they are all going to die. He said, right. Didn't say I'm going to die.
No, he was implying that I would be out of here by the time that shit hits the thing. Yeah.
That is no oracle.
Open the gate!
What do you mean? No, don't open the gate.
Oh, y'all got the prayers were answered. That's an elvish flag right there.
That's an elf?
Bows, yeah.
Wow.
Bro, it's the cat elf that's come to us.
Chelf.
An alliance once existed between elves and men. Long ago we fought. Died.
Yes, hell yes.
We come to honor that allegiance.
Cold chills, that's pretty awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was pretty sweet.
Aww.
Gimli!
Give him an apple box to stand on.
Of course.
The eye of Sauron sends his regards.
Are there women amongst the elves too?
I didn't see any.
Yeah.
They're all so androgynous, you'll never know.
They have very feminine faces.
Yeah, I see ladies. I see ladies.
Yeah.
You don't need to feel bad.
They're
slaughtering
so
these
soggy
fuckers.
And gross.
What's happening out there? Shall I describe it to you, or would you like me to find you a box?
Let's go, baby.
I'm ready.
Get geeked.
God, this shit is so epic.
No.
Way to get it though. At least he killed somebody.
You walked all this way to die first.
You should be shooting at them by now.
Right?
Come on. Ah, there we go. Make it rain.
I love how theirs are so precise.
Like they're like literally right there, dude. They have ladders.
Look at the volume.
Top of them too. They start on top. That's so smart.
Yeah.
Oh, damn, bro.
Shit. I'm sorry. There's way too many of them. This is not gonna work out.
Wilhelm!
That was such a blatant Wilhelm.
Yeah, it was.
We'll never not be hyped for Wilhelm.
Never.
Oh my god, guys, shut up and focus.
Damn it, bro.
Actually,
do they
have dicks?
Right
they have.
No, they don't make.
Y'all
talk so slow.
I know.
God.
And?
Yes?
Did he fall asleep?
You are not orcs.
Oh my god.
Our friends are out there. They need our help.
Damn, look at this like a sea of motherfuckers.
Like, literally, how is this even gonna work out?
Shit. I love this. Oh my god, I love this so much.
Is this all you can conjure?
Shut the fuck up. What you got?
Yeah, don't ever say that. Literally, like, rule number one is don't ever say, oh, this is easy. What could go wrong? Like, never ever say that.
Why is nobody looking at this? Their one weakness?
I know. Like,
Death Star, they don't know it.
Look at this guy.
That looks fun, man.
Olympic fire torch.
Yeah, it's cool until you don't exist anymore.
Let's go, Legolas. Let's go, bro. You are the king of this. Oh, this guy is...
Bro, look.
And Maniac was the finish line. Oh. He went in. Oh.
Bro.
They have been fully infiltrated. It's done.
You guys are fucked. See ya.
Holy
shit. In the next life.
Blow the whole bridge up. Fuck it.
Oh, come on. You
guys, come
on.
That's
come
the plan? You could have put anything there.
That was him.
Threw a spear.
They have reached the gate.
Electrocute the puddle. Aragorn, get the fuck out!
Oh!
You try and get the count. Damn.
Shit. So cool.
No.
I love this. Oh, you fucking shitting me.
Confirmed?
Okay. We have a skateboard. We're doing this. Chest.
That's so cool.
You're part of this world.
He was literally going to burn your fucking forest.
Your part in this cave is over. Go back to your home.
I literally don't stop.
I do like the Ents, but their decision is dumb as fuck. Yeah, it makes absolutely no literally. Sense. They're like, we're not a part of this forest. Like, he's going to burn your forest. He said it. You know it. He's doing it.
We got the Shire.
It's got to be burned, too.
Maybe we should go.
No, y'all have come this far.
Fires of Isengard will spread.
Yeah, eventually the Shire's going to get fucked. Frodo sainted in the water.
There won't be a Shire.
Mary's thinking.
Where's the Gandalf? Where's the wizard at?
I'm saying, bro.
Like, bring his ass over here, shit.
Don't distract him.
Yeah, right.
Ah, jeez. Oh. That sounded like it was next
no,
to me.
No, I don't want him to die.
Not the child.
Gotta be some casualties now.
Yeah.
Oh, God! So many elves.
Is this Sin Me?
Is he on there?
Yo!
Yes, this is the shit I'm talking about.
Yeah! Ooh.
Do it, stab him. Bitch, yes. Yeah, right?
It's gotta motivate the men seeing the king fight. Oh, no, he's gone immediately.
Still though, he got a couple.
You guys have no other strategy.
Oh my god, this is so great, Pat. You're gonna love this. I love this.
Oh, back door.
It's a long way. Push me.
He and Legolas have such a good competition.
Into the gambling!
What the?
Into the thick of it!
You love this so much.
Oh shit!
God, it's so awesome.
Just two fucking of them. Yeah, reinforce this shit. How did these two last out here?
This is the dream team, baby!
How the fuck?
Go!
Oh my god.
Oh no!
God!
Oh. Holy fuck! The ladder's going up behind him. This is fucking crazy, dude.
Hold them back.
It's time to retreat.
Look at, oh my, oh, they're spilling
so
in,
they're
bro.
So they just pushed.
Turn around, take a circle.
And that will lead you past Isengard.
We can slip past Saruman unnoticed.
Saruman?
The closer we are to danger, the farther we are from harm.
It doesn't seem to serve to me. But then you are very small, as you right.
Yeah,
this tree's been smoking himself.
Can we go back in a fight?
I know. Can come away.
Hey, here's a thing you should have noticed.
Yep, and this is why you should get involved.
Many of these trees were my friends.
I'm sorry, Treebeard.
Pippin knew.
Now we're talking faster.
Also, kind of selfish of the trees not to want to get involved until they know that they're being burned, but like, Jesus.
They weren't friends with men for a while, because, let's face it, we all
they didn't
the
like
trees,
the orcs and stuff.
This table is made out of his brother.
March of the Ents!
Yay!
Nice.
Oh, we got the eggs involved now with the dwarves and men and everything.
What? Smeagol, go!
Punch him some more.
The orcs will take an eastern shore. By nightfall, we'll be overrun. Take them to my father.
God damn it, you son of a fucking...
You want to know what happened to Boromir?
Tell him.
He tried to take the ring from Frodo. He tried to get it. The ring drove your brother mad.
They're here. They've come.
His eyes look like golems now.
No, that's
the way
what I'm saying. Their eyes look the same.
Well, now you fucked up. Should have mentioned that shit about Boromir earlier.
Yeah, I don't know why they didn't do that.
How much can you put up? Aren't they breached in the other side of the wall, too?
Yes, yes.
But it's smart to keep, like, retreating to the safer.
This is their last hideout.
You said this fortress would never fall and your men defend it. They still defend it. They have died defending it.
Send word for the women and children to make for the mountain pass.
Yeah. There's something to be done.
What can men do against such reckless hate?
Go down fighting, King.
Yeah,
come on.
King giving up?
Philosophical right now?
The King has just gave up, bro. He's done.
Right out and meet them. For death and glory.
Yes.
A Rohan, your sun is rising.
Look to my coming at first sight in the fifth.
Oh my god.
Yo, here.
That's what I was saying. I was like, what is the fucking fifth day?
The horn of hell, Hammerhand, shall sound in the deep one last time.
Let's get it.
Yes, now for wrath, now for ruin, and a red gold.
Let's go.
I love it.
Oh,
my God. Oh, God.
They're on
indoors.
Horses inside, yeah. Let's go, let's go, let's go. This has to be my favorite part right now. This is hilarious.
Right? This is a solid strategy.
Oh my God.
My God.
A sea of people.
Ah! I've been waiting for you.
Motherfucking took a sweet ass time.
I know, but he said
he said exactly what he
came exactly on time.
No, he's never late. Time. Or early.
Thank God Gandalf is not. He's not Indian.
It's the veil.
Eowyn's brother. Helm's motherfucking deep.
Ooh, look at him. They're going in,
this
bro.
This is very much exciting right now.
The light.
Damn, blind him, bro. Yes.
Bro, Gandalf legit looks like majestic and angelic and like the spirit
that
he is.
I mean, he's on the king, the lord, the horse, the lord of horses.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is, how do you even get that title if you're a horse?
Fuck up, I hey. Break that whole shit down, bro.
Like,
oh my god!
Yo.
Bro, they're shitty. I wish this is the consequence of global warming. Jeez!
No! No! No!
He looks disheveled as fuck.
Yeah, fuck you, Simon.
I love this.
Damn.
Bro, he just chucked that dude into the water.
Yeah, fuck it.
Hell,
how about
yes.
Those fires of Isengard, guys?
Hey, homie, who's on fire? Dump his head.
Yes! Yes!
So none of the Ents died, yeah?
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
Saruman's people, like, between, like, at the deep and right here, they're all, like, losing by the
come
numbers.
Come on, Frodo.
Damn, fuck.
Get a hold of yourself.
Next movie, Frodo's with Sauron.
Yup.
Like, look at him.
Come on, they're gonna see you.
I think he wants to go.
Yeah.
Oh, good friend, good fucking friend. Bro, Sam, the real one.
For real.
What the fuck, Frodo?
It's your Sam.
They're not gonna care what anybody says.
Frodo, you've been doing so well, buddy. This must be so hard.
Imagine what that ring's doing,
bro. Yeah.
I can't do this. It's like the great stories, Mr. Frodo. The ones that really matter. Folk in those stories had lots of chances of turning back, only they didn't. Because they were holding on to something. What are we holding on to, Sam? There's some good in this world, Mr. Frodo.
There's always hope.
And it's worth fighting.
You need that pep talk every once in a while. It's really good, Sam King.
Sam's great. Sam is great. Fuck you.
We understand one another, Frodo Baggins. Let them go, your life will be forfeit. And it is forfeit.
Cheers to you, bro. They're retreating?
Oh,
chase them.
That's sweet. You all think you're safe in the forest?
Can you kill him?
Yup.
Zoink.
That's sick.
Let's go, Mother Earth.
Once again, absolutely terrifying.
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. That is
scary. I love
scary.
This. This was my favorite part of the movie.
When the trees murdered the bed.
Yeah.
42.
42? Bro, he jumped in, bitch.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Gimli beat him.
I myself am sitting pretty on 43.
What the fuck?
It was already dead.
He was twitching.
It has got my axe embedded in its chest.
So fucked up.
He's right now. Give you go, Gimli.
I'm just starving. Good luck trying to find something decent to eat around here.
There's some apples. Is that a chicken?
The whole chicken.
I'll eat it.
Oh, hell
if
no.
If I'm desperate, bro.
Right?
I mean, if you haven't eaten in days, I'm
yeah,
sure
I'm
that's looking pretty good.
A little wet chicken
will
turn me
on. Oh, wine?
That's good.
Yeah, bitch, I'm doing it.
Oh, I'm
smoked.
There you go.
Meat.
South fart.
No, that's the weed.
Yeah. Bro, light it up.
Yeah.
Got that long bottom leaf face. Where the fuck?
Yeah,
young wizard, where'd that come from?
Yeah.
All right. He's like, shit, let me hit that, boy.
I like the throat kind of coming out of there.
What road will you take when you reach the woods?
Gorm says there's a path near Minas Morgul that climbs up into the mountain.
Stop touching him!
They say a dark terror dwells in the passes above Minas Morgul.
I believe him.
Jesus.
I think it says a lot about you based on the way you treat Smeeks.
Well, meanwhile, I swear to God, Faramir, I'm gonna beat you up myself! Okay, that's nice, yep. But you don't have to do it like that.
Yep.
Like, maybe if you treated him nice, he would treat you guys nice too, you know?
The battle for Helm's Deep is over. The battle for Middle-earth is about to begin. All our hopes now lie with two little hobbits.
So good.
No, Smeagol's listening to Gollum now.
Who's her?
Who the fuck is her?
You'll find out in the next movie.
God, we lost Smeagol.
I can't blame him.
We lost Smeagol.
Fucking got his ass beat.
Oh god.
And
no!
Guys,
but there is so much more.
No, yeah, there is.
There's so much more.
There is one last chunk of the pool.
One more movie. You guys have done it. You guys have done it.
You've gotten through
Lord.
It.
Tell me how you
I like
failed.
This one better than the first one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Who this was
the Helm's Deep shit, huh?
Yeah.
The Helm's Deep was fucking wild.
So yeah, just for context, yeah, that inspired so much of what Game of Thrones has done. Some literary terms, George R.R. Martin took so much inspiration from J.R.R. Tolkien in terms of killing off characters, as I think I talked about before, but in terms of Peter Jackson's influence, this, you know, sequence of Helm's Deep has influenced so much of these
battle sequences. One something you guys were saying?
It won a lot of awards from like Oscar and other academic awards, but MTV Movie Awards, it was like best scene or whatever.
It was
whatever.
So hype
because
Helm's
Deep, and everyone's like,
just like going ham. Tolkien,
that's like very crazy to me. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
Super old dude.
All this stuff. Yeah.
Fought in World War I and like lost.
Who?
Tolkien, the writer,
the author of the books. Yeah.
He literally fought in World War I.
Well, yes. And he had sons that fought in World War II, and I think he lost a lot of friends in World War I, which was like part of his inspiration for like the Fellowship and like breaking up and like trying to go again. It's like this whole thing, and also I think. Can't remember if America was isolationist in World War I or not, but knowing us, we probably kind of were.
I just know that it's all like these are all basically big allegories written from an English author in a post World War I, post World War II environment.
It's interesting.
It's a lot of allegories for war, which
that's
is why they
fun
show.
Fact, I'm not gonna lie.
It's why they show so many dead. You know, it's a reason why they kind of show the horrors of war. I mean, they Peter Jackson kind of glamorizes it because he loves the subject matter so much and he portrays it so well, but they also try to do their best to show.
And that's why maybe he picked up like this movie.
And so it's like deforestation, all of like this machination, this industry, all this
shit. Like Battle of the Bastards and like, you know, Blackwater wouldn't have existed or wouldn't have looked the way they looked if it weren't for this.
Right, exactly.
Sure.
It's like really cool when people like this Peter character actually like have a passion and interest. That's actually what makes the movie even better, because like they put their heart and soul into it. Like, no, it has to be this way.
And I do want to actually say that Dameron, I think you are right, because he wrote the book in between 37 and 49, which would have been when World War II was happening, and then still writing it after it's ended. Yeah,
I think that their whole thing, I think the allegory, and this is my assuming thing, so everybody in the audience, please fact check me here, but I would assume that their allegory of the Ents being in America is the fact that it's kind of the Wild West, if you will, to Europe at least, you know, or the rest of the world, and so they took forever to join the war.
Mm-hmm. And then when we did, you know, it was
influential, like, right? Yeah. So that's my perception of all of it. But anyway, yes, to the back to the actual story, it's fantastic. You know,
this is a really good continuation. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
I was like, the second half definitely was more hype, obviously, but the information in the first half is very like important and everything.
It's a lot of build up.
It is a lot of build up. Yeah. Like, I really enjoyed. It, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, you get all the character building in the first movie, The Fellowship. It kind of establishes all these characters and the stakes, and then you get to this movie where you kind of see To your point, Serge, like it being kind of like an empire thing, you see the dark side of this story kind of deliver on its promise. Like there's a real threat here.
Yeah.
You're
yeah.
hearing about it in the first movie. You actually see it in the second movie.
Yeah. Kind of thing. Yeah. My thing with comparing to Star Wars was like the original trilogy. New Hope, good guys win. Empire, bad guys,
sure,
strike
sure.
back.
Sure.
And then the Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
this return is in the name of the final film too, but
sure.
it feels like the opposite. It feels like we kind of lost in Fellowship. Everyone
right.
split up.
Correct.
There was a big victory here.
Right.
And so like what awaits us in the third movie? I won't spoil.
Yeah.
But yeah, Pat, run out, you guys more.
You guys
so.
Take us out.
And my chair. It was good. I liked the second half better than the first half. I think
what did you like about it?
I think it was just a lot more action-packed.
Yeah.
Like, it was just, yep. like, I think once we saw the two meet, I think it was, like, about 40 minutes of just nonstop action. So
and,
that
like, Gandalf coming in.
Yeah, so that was dope.
Sure.
And also, Gandalf should have came earlier. He fucked up on that.
He told him. He said he'd be here 5 minutes.
He was on time.
Yeah.
Okay, well, you could also be early. There's a thing. You could also be early.
Not coming from this crowd. I don't want to hear it.
If you, recall,
you could also be early.
If you recall, in the first movie, he says to Frodo in the very beginning of the film, a wizard arrives exactly when he needs
oh,
to.
Yes.
Says, I don't exactly. arrive early,
or
I don't
late.
Arrive late.
When he
I
needs to.
Exactly.
So did you see how many people died? Did you see that one Chad Elf die?
Oh, shit.
Did you like the big old bomb?
There, like, huh? His name was
the big bomb when they blew up the wall.
Yeah.
Oh, that was
yeah.
dope.
You were stoked. Dude did like a, it was like touchdown die.
Right. Yeah. Like,
what song
Go
plays
us.
When like that person runs with the torch?
Yeah.
The song that always plays.
Yeah, exactly.
The ladders, like a lot of that shit was practical. You could
yeah.
see
yeah,
like the
and,
effects.
Like, I think other movies, like, and also like, I know in Game of Thrones, like, they would put the ladder up first, and then people would go up.
Mm-hmm.
These motherfuckers were already on the ladder, and then they went up. So that's
yeah,
like
yeah, yeah.
that's a lot better strategy.
Like
yeah.
Yeah.
I think the thing that hooked them.
The way that Game of Thrones was trying to do it was in like the in medieval
historical
times, according
context.
To medieval warfare, this is how you would do it. People weren't
right.
on top of the ladders, but here they're like, these orcs are fucking wild, bro.
Yeah.
They said literally 50 of y'all get on the ladder, another 75 of y'all pull that motherfucker up. And
yeah.
just like, blah,
when you
which
got 10,000, you can throw fucking 100 people on a ladder and pull them up.
Also, didn't you say orcs were brainless and dumb? So, like,
so there's the orcs, and then there's
the
Uruk-hai. The Uruk-hai are these ones. They're a little bit
like
more sentient,
generous.
I guess. They're
breeded in that one room. Where
yeah,
some
yeah,
of them
they're ripping them out of the goose egg.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So they're kind of like the dominant.
They're a little bit smarter.
Class.
Like they were the ones at the beginning when Merry and Pippin were still being dragged by them. The lesser orcs were like, let's eat them, but the Uruk-hai were like, no,
great.
We have orcs.
Because he had
yeah.
sort of the bigger plan.
Yeah, orcs,
yeah.
I guess, are more subject to their lower impulses. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
They don't really have the ability to discern between
foresight.
I'm hungry and here's profit
yeah.
in the long term.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whereas Uruk-hai, maybe they just know,
they,
I think they're more like soldiers and they're just like, I have a direct
orders.
Instruction and this is what I'm going to
mm-hmm.
do,
yeah.
kind of a thing. Yeah, exactly. They're bred for war, as
love
Saruman
that.
Said.
And it's getting absolute payback in the end.
Yes.
Yep.
They're like, oh, shit, this affects us now. Yeah, it's definitely American.
It's kind of shitty, though, that he had to see it affect them to get into it.
That's definitely America in World War II.
Yeah.
I know that we were giving
hey,
supplies and shit
true.
Before, but
that,
we could have been.
That furthers the point.
Right?
The
we could have
yeah.
been in there, and it was
it
like
does.
Pearl Harbor happened.
But like,
yeah. this
yeah.
will not stand.
I mean, it was good
yeah.
they got into it, but it was like, at that point, it was like too, like, almost too late. Like, what the fuck?
But it's not, right? History tells us it's not. Didn't come into
but
the
you see how many people
late.
Die?
And it's just crazy that we had like 10,000 of like the bad guys, but no 300 of our people, children, everything, but yet literally the 10,000 die.
Which
and,
once again.
Well, and well, they ran, some
with
ran
the
off, but the
reinforcements
and
then
the elves came.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
But,
sorry, elves.
Yeah,
reinforcements.
The story is the story of 300 like a real actual war tactic
yes.
where like they
yes.
use the environment. So if you got that many people all trying to funnel into one point, you can
like
use your environment.
I've never
yeah.
seen.
And then they like they drop back even after
yeah.
they get to a certain point. They weren't even all the way retreating. They're like drop back, send these people here. Like they were still using strategy and using the space that they had,
that was
which
smart.
Is tight because that's what you need to do, especially considering that. I mean, look, 10,000 is all good, but you even saw when they came out there riding on the horses. That like 50,000 of them are like more than half
yeah.
are still outside.
I wonder
I mean,
if that
even
was a
the
historical reference.
Revolutionary War, like the Redcoats, the British, greatly outnumbered all like Americans as we know them today. Like we
yeah.
had fucking pitchforks and rocks, and we
use
were able
card?
To pick them off because British would the troops the British troops would march like the orcs, like
right.
in a big block,
yeah.
just marching forward, never
right.
breaking that formation.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
it was just like
Yeah, and right. The Americans right. Just like, let's get in the woods.
Right. Know, because we know the land, and they didn't know the land. We used that shit to our advantage. So when you have numbers like that, if you don't have the strategy, and you think that you're just going to use your numbers to overwhelm them, you can still get out fucking played.
You'll suffer you might win, but you'll suffer greater losses to the point where you're like, is this even worth it?
You can win the battle, but maybe not the war.
Dude, this battle is phenomenal. Like literally every single part. Like when you're in the horses inside, I'm like, you guys got fucking horses inside.
I know. Well, yeah. Well, you gotta stable them. But I wonder if that is a Battle of Thermopylae reference to the 300 because they
mentioned 300
so maybe historically that's a you haven't seen the 300 okay it's a great movie but the story is that there were 300 Spartans that defended themselves against an invading I think it was the Persian Empire which was huge at the time and they were invading Greece and the way that they stopped them was they took 300 Spartans but they brought them to an impasse like a canyon. And so all of the Persians' numbers amounted for nothing because they had to funnel them into this tiny little impasse.
Yeah.
And it was the same kind of a thing at Helm's Deep where you see all the Uruk-hai running up the ramp. Doesn't really matter what their numbers are if the only area to breach they have is a very narrow pathway.
That's say words.
Yeah.
Guys, well, I was listening to you guys. Yeah. I said before the trees were my favorite part because, you know, me.
Even the slow speaking parts and everything?
A what?
The slow speaking parts.
Yeah, I didn't mind it. I mean, it was different in the theater. I don't remember exactly like if there was an extra scenes added and making this longer. But I didn't mind it in the theater. I remember like being most hyped, especially like when they let the water out and they were able to just stand in the water and everything was just like.
Yes. Yeah, that's so cool.
It was like a great payback.
The guy that Gandalf came with, Butchie.
Mm-hmm.
He left. He got exiled. So how did he have a big ass army to come with?
Because he got exiled with a group of.
No, there was only a small group that he brought.
He was with Gandalf, and Gandalf probably like was.
Yeah,
able
but how
to
get that army though? Like that's Butchie's army.
What I'm
though,
saying
right?
is like on his way. I mean, we didn't see what happened. I don't know why that wasn't in the movie, but like you know, Saruman probably.
What a surprise!
Gandalf was probably able to like grab more people around as well as Butchie.
Oh, so it's not just Butchie's army.
Yeah,
I like
know.
How we're calling him Butchie.
Butchie.
Yeah, that's why I call him in my live streams. Everybody made fun of me.
Because The Wire, the guy's name is Butchie also.
Yeah. Also plays Bones in Star Trek.
Blind Butchie.
I really, really appreciate Sam's character more than ever. Mm-hmm. He is so loyal, so dedicated, so trustworthy, and just like a good hobbit all around.
Good
and,
friend.
Like, literally.
Friend. Not once has he tried to like be like,
no.
Take the ring or anything
or
like that.
Or try to go back or think of himself or anything. No, bro, he's like in it.
Motivating him.
And like, even in the Fellowship of the First movie, they were like, where Gandalf died and everything. You see Sam like, jumping and he's here in the second movie jumping again.
People have made jokes of it, but like the subtext is definitely there. When he's just like, he's
what,
at the front of the neck.
Of
them like being like a romantic couple.
Yes.
Oh my god.
Don't you recognize your Sam? Like, who's ever been? If someone, I don't know.
That was our
outside of the juvenile thing, you could have made a play for it.
Regardless.
How many times have you heard the, I know how it all is, but how many times have you heard Frodo mention, like, oh man, ladies and shit? It could have been cute.
Regardless.
Samwise wanted to bang the bitty waitress at the Shire.
He could want both.
Waitress, oh my god.
If their message is there, I think it's
the,
fine.
The only people I could actually see being in the show is that one king, the old king, like the king who fell off into the river.
Aragorn?
Aragorn?
Yeah.
And
the elf.
Elf. Those two I could see.
Rule 34 exists.
Well, I think their whole relationship is based on the fact that Aragorn was kind of, as he said, for a time raised in Rivendell, so he knows a lot of the elvish culture and language, so they kind of have a bond. He wasn't raised with the dwarves, for example. He was raised with the elves. But I see your point.
I just felt like they had more of a thing.
I'm not trying to make a joke of it. I'm just saying, like,
I agree.
I'm just very glad I'm sharing this movie with you guys. Like this, the shield part where what's his name?
Legolas
ride down the shield.
That's what you can do in the game.
I know. Yeah. It's so funny that you say that because you guys are always talking about Breath of the Wild, but there's much influence.
You're right. He's late, bro. He's straight up extra late.
Forgot about the part where the Aragorn and Gimli are fighting on the.
Oh my god, they're gonna be so high.
Mount Doom, Death Mountain.
Dude, in the theaters, I remember when he tossed him out there, I was just like, what is this movie? Like, what is happening right here? Yeah.
Aragorn opening the door in his slow motion hair, I'm like, that's bae.
See why Eowyn wants that? Yeah, and I like the character of Eowyn too. She's like,
she wants to fight, you know, she's there. She's constantly being told not to. If Shield Maidens existed, I don't know.
Exactly.
But, you know,
they're not gonna, acknowledged it.
He just lost his son. He had to bury his son, so he wasn't about to let his niece ride out into battle. So I understand that. I don't think it would really matter if she was a boy or not.
Anybody who's skilled in combat should be eligible, especially if they want to be fighting, to fight. There's like, there was no use for her. She was just standing around. I mean, come on. Like, you put a 5-year-old boy because he has a penis. That is not, that does not qualify him to be a good fighter.
I mean, but that 5-year-old boy was not the king's son. That's the thing. Like, she was the niece.
She the next, was if trained the king, in battle.
I get you, but if the king was supposed to die in that battle, who's going to take care? It was going to be the niece, so you want to make sure at least his leniency keeps
all
right. going.
In all fairness, I will give you that, and I'll give you that, but can you think that if he had a son that was literally a fucking soldier like everyone else, he'd be like, hey, I'm going to go out and fight?
Yeah,
son,
if he just, his son, if he just buried one of his sons, I don't want my other son. If I know if I'm going to die, I
but know Boromir just died. People. We see this other king being like, Faramir, go out there and go be useful, you dumb fuck.
I don't know. If you see in Game of Thrones, they keep Tommen and the other boy in there
because
they
give the next heir to the king.
To play the whole historical context of it, if this were a historical battle, the typically the daughter, niece, what have you, be protected because they can sustain the family lineage. So they are protected. They're not encouraged to go into battle, even if they are. Life I'm just saying, in a historical, real world, historical context, that's why.
It's to protect the bloodline.
It's to select, yeah, the bloodline. Yeah, exactly. That's exactly it.
Whether or not that's fair, it's
a totally different question.
Yeah, it's like, you know? Whatever. But like, yeah. Think about it. They didn't do this, and we probably wouldn't have some of these bloodlines right now.
Right. So, anyway.
Man, I'm not gonna lie, this was a very good movie. I hope we see more Liv Tyler, because I really
enjoyed it. So, I do want to talk about one thing.
What?
Let Neil Practice Harris comment. When did he come out? Because he had How I Met Your Mother. That's when I actually knew
him. If you come out in Hollywood, you've been known to get less roles. Neil Patrick Harris, the guy who plays Siler in Heroes. He's also Spock in the new Star Trek movies.
There's also do you know the actor Neil McCaffrey in that one show, White Collar? He's a great actor, but I don't see him that many roles either. He's gay.
Yeah, it's like an unspoken thing, but it is happening. That's all I'm saying. It's like,
I don't know when did he come out. Like, was it, like recently? Because like, I remember I seen him a lot on TV when I was younger, and then now I'm not seen as much. I don't know what time period.
Let me interject. This is hearsay. This is me just recalling shit off of what I've read and heard. So, internet, don't devour me if I say this incorrectly. I'm pretty sure Sir Ian McKellen is gay as well. Gandalf.
Yes.
Pretty sure he is.
The wizard?
Gandalf.
I believe so. Yeah. I mean, I'm
pretty sure.
Actually, I don't know. I'm pretty sure.
We have the internet.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. So,
is Gandalf
obviously,
gay?
There's nothing wrong with being gay. We're fully supportive of everybody. We're just making commentary about this right now.
Ian McKellen is gay.
Yeah. Man, all in all, I freaking loved this movie. Mm-hmm. It was really good. Mm-hmm. 10 out of 10 for me. Seriously.
Dope. Two Towers is great.
Yeah, Two Towers is phenomenal. Honestly, the next one has a lot of, you know.
You've got a lot of loose ends to tie up.
Well, the only loose end is to just drop the ring. Saruman's dead, right?
No.
Saruman's still alive.
No, he's up there in the water.
Saruman and Sauron. He's up in his tower. He's surrounded on all sides.
He lost his army, but he can't really do anything.
He's got magic. You don't know what he can do.
Well, in theory, he can't recuperate from losing an army. He can't build another army.
He's connected to Sauron. Like, he has the eyeball in his house. He can probably go to fucking like one tower
stone.
Has fallen right out
the
of the two.
Stone. Yes, yeah, yeah.
So well, I mean, he can still escape from his situation.
But like, they don't have to worry about like any of the worst. Like, the only objective now.
Frodo is literally drunk on power.
Yeah, Gandalf said like the retaliation will be swift. And there's in Mordor, there's like a whole big ass army. Do you remember you saw them going into the gate? Like, the trolls were opening that big-ass gate, people were turning, so, like, there's a whole shit ton there. Yeah, that's where Frodo has to go.
Or it's like a breeze.
I thought the mountain is just like a mountain, you just go drop it
in. Oh, no, there's an army.
It is, but it's like, deep in there.
You could view Mordor as like the original location, and then Saruman's tower was like the pilot location where he was just starting an army, where they had like a fucking full army in Mordor. They were like, how about you start one up over here and get it going?
Oh,
and
so
then
he was just like,
yeah, sure, and then it backfired, and now
he's scared for Frodo, bro. He keeps getting
Saruman. You worry about Frodo, I'm worried about Gollum over here. That motherfucker two-timing home, man. I swear to God. Like, seriously, how you gonna flip
I
like
believe
that?
In Smeagol!
No, listen, I get you on that, like, but
What's his phrase? Frodo was actually saving him when he went down there and like get him out of there because the old boy up there is going to kill his ass. So like Frodo, like the with a seagull, he should have known that Frodo was trying to save
Benny
his
Siegel.
Ass.
Benny Siegel.
Well, last thing I want to say is that this movie is amazing.
It is.
But I fucking hate movies that last almost 4 hours.
Oh, come on.
I don't understand why.
Because I love it. It's more content.
I understand. Content. But then, like, I get it. And if I could just watch it at home, like, 1 hour at a time, I would have enjoyed it more than 4 hours in one sitting.
This was before shows were, like, theatrical releases. So, I mean, the Lord of the Rings series that Amazon paid $500,000 for the rights to just do, that's not even the budget for the show. They paid $500,000 to be able to produce a show.
Yeah.
That's coming out soon. Might be more
I'll be excited to watch that. Me too. Internet, say what you will about me. You already know how I feel. It's long. It is long. If it's a series, because then we can have like, boom, we get this ending. And I'm like, hell yeah, like, let's roll with that. Most movies aren't this fucking long, bro.
Okay, except for like 2.5 hours. Never mind.
The extended edition adds like 45 minutes. Yeah. So it's still pretty long even without the extended stuff.
They're about like two, I think the theatrical, they're more like 2:30, somewhere around there. So about adds like an hour and some. But like in the Return of the King, I think it was more like three. I think Return of the King was like a proper full 3 hours.
Return of the King, we're gonna have to split that in days.
Yeah. So that no one
we got this done in one day, but that one, I'm sorry, y'all. We're gonna have to.
It's a big one.
So no one is upset. I'm talking to them. I wasn't trying to shut you down like that. I'm sorry. I'm just talking directly to them. I'm not saying that the movie sucks. I'm not saying that you shouldn't like it.
The movie's
great. The movie.
Snyder.
It's just really long. If the Snyder cut was shorter, I would have liked it. Most people can fit that kind of content into smaller packages.
Snyder, right? It's put it in parts, bro.
To Marquette's point, it did take me about 3 days to watch the Snyder.
What?
I broke it up in parts, and you know what? I will say it is better than theatrical release, and I would say that it's Zack Snyder's best DC movie.
I want to say one last thing before we say bye. And now all it is if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Consider supporting us on Patreon. It helps. If you've made it to the end of this video and you were just discovering us through this, we're the normies. We do this kind of stuff, and we do it off the goodwill of our patrons. It makes us all possible to be here holding in our pee for 4 hours.
So bad.
We're doing it for y'all because we love doing this with each other, but with y'all as well. So please, if you made it this far, at least like this video. Thank you very much.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye. Bye.